Go to the Firefox add-ons page and do a search for a simple screen recorder. I built this application using ChatGPT. This screen recorder can record your web pages or screens at different video qualities and downloads it directly into your downloads folder. Let's go over to ChatGPT so I can show you how I built this. For the prompt, type in, generate code for a simple Chrome extension that allows the users to record their screen and audio. The extension should open an HTML tab to display the interface and should not be a pop-up window. The interface displays a start button and a stop button, as well as a quality selector for the video recording. When the user clicks on the start button, the extension should begin recording and display a real-time timer that shows how long the user has been recording. When the user clicks on the stop button, the extension should stop recording and save the video file to the user's downloads folder. The user should be able to select the quality of the video recording from a drop-down menu. Use JavaScript, MediaRecorder API. Please list the files needed without the code. Now ChatGPT is generating our code. ChatGPT encountered an error. Let's regenerate the response. ChatGPT provided us with a list of files we will need. We will need a manifest.json file, a popup.html file, a popup.js file, and a background.js file. Let's stop ChatGPT from giving us the rest of the code. We will ask for the files individually. Ask ChatGPT for the manifest.json code. Now let's ask for the background.js code. Ask for the popup.js code. ChatGPT was taking too long to write the code, so I regenerated the response. Ask for the popup.html code. Now that our code is ready, let's head over to Visual Studio. Here in the project, I have an icons folder that's holding all the icons for the project. Let's create a new file. Let's call it manifest.json. Copy the code and paste it. Save the file. Create a background.js file. Go to the code, copy it, paste it, save the file, create a popup.js file, copy the code, paste the code, save the file, and let's create our popup.html file, copy the code, save the file. Now the code should be ready. Let's head over to the top right hand corner of our Chrome browser, click the menu icon, select more tools, then click on extensions. Click on load unpack. Select the folder that holds your extension. It looks like we encountered an error. It can't find the manifest.json file. Let's head back to the code and see what's going on. Looks like I made the mistake of creating all the files inside of the icons folder. Let's drag out all the files out of the icons folder and into the root folder. Let's also take a look at our manifest.json file to see what the path is for our icons. It looks like the path for the icons is also pointing to the root, so let's just drag all the images out of the folder and place it into the root. Let's go back to Chrome, select retry. There, now our app has been uploaded to our Chrome browser with our icon. Now let's go to the top right and select the extensions icon. Select the pin icon right by our extension. This will pin our extension right on the toolbar. Okay, now let's test our extension. As you can see, our extension opens up as a pop-up window, which is not what we wanted. Let's go back into ChatGPT. Let's type in, I need this plugin to open in a new tab and not as a pop-up window. please provide the updated manifest. Copy the code, paste the code. It looks like ChatGPT has changed our icon names. Let's change them back. When names are changed, I tend to ask ChatGPT for updated code for all the files, just to make sure we're on the same page to eliminate any future errors. Save the file. Ask for the popup.js code. For the background.js code. Copy the code. And paste the code. It looks like ChatGPT replaced our popup.html file for index.html. Let's change that back to popup.html. Save the file. Ask to provide the HTML code. Doesn't look like anything has changed with the HTML file, so I'm not going to copy that. Go back into our browser's extensions page. Click the refresh icon here to update the code. Let's test our plugin. So now it opens up in a new tab, which is great, but it looks like we have an issue when we click on a record button. Nothing's happening. Let's right-click on the page, select inspect. It looks like we have an error here on our console. Let's copy this error code and paste it into ChatGPT. Looks like the error has something to do with our popup.js file. So let's ask ChatGPT to provide us with an updated version. Copy the code, paste the code, and save the file. Now let's go back to the extensions page, refresh the extension code, come on our extension. Looks like the drop-down menu is working, but our recording button is still not working. So let's right-click, go to inspect, and looks like we still have an error in our console log. So let's copy this error and paste it into ChatGPT. It looks like the error has something to do with our popup.html file. So let's ask ChatGPT to provide us an updated version. Copy the code. Paste the code and save the file. Here in the code, it looks like it's referencing another file that we don't have, called popup.css. The popup.html will be the web page, and the popup.css will be responsible for the styling of the web page. So let's ask ChatGPT to provide us with the popup.css code. Let's create a new file called popup.css. Now let's copy the code, paste the code, save the file. Now let's go back to the extensions page and refresh the code. Now let's click on our extension and now our application is looking a lot better. And now let's click on start recording. And now let's select the page that we want to start recording and click share. Now it's recording. Let's head over to ChatGPT and type in thank you and wait for the reply. Okay. Now, let's hit stop recording. It immediately downloads the file here. Let's open up the file. And now you can see that the video is playing. And that's it. Now we have a full functioning screen recorder that records at different qualities, records your entire screen with audio, and shows you a timer of how long you've been recording for. And now you can take this plugin and sell it on the Chrome or Firefox web store. I did not write any code. All this code was written using ChatGPT. If you want to see something created with ChatGPT, let me know in the comments below. If you like this content, give it a thumbs up and subscribe.